반갑습니다. Welcome to K-Wellness TV. Almost every one of us is overtired and overworked from time to time. When that happens, usually we know the cause. For example, we didn't sleep well the previous night, or we just had a large meal, or we had a jet lag, or we worked too much the other day. And usually when we take rest well, then we feel much better. But sometimes, even after we take a rest, we still feel exhausted. Why? It is not easy to recover from this constant state of weariness. It reduces your energy, motivation, and concentration. Fatigue at this level will impact you in an emotional and psychological level too. I was an IT project manager before. I was responsible for the whole team and the whole project. I had to take care of planning and organizing, and also I had to allocate the resources well and make sure we meet the tight deadlines. And I had to communicate well between many teams and experts who is taking care of the software development and hardware installation and then visual design and also strategic planning and user interface designers. Some people were night owls and others were early birds. So communicating between them was so challenging. And it was me who was responsible for the outcome for my customers. So even after coming home, even during the holidays, I felt anxious. What if I made mistakes? What if the project is delayed because of me? So there are many nights that I couldn't sleep very well, and I felt more tired, and so on. I felt, this is how people get burnt out. Fatigue is a state that your energy is reduced. As I mentioned in the previous video, we have the physical body, energy body, and the spiritual body. They are made up of energy. When you go deeper into our body, we have organs, tissues, cells, molecules, and atoms. The atoms are made up of a nucleus and electrons. And if the nucleus was expanded to the size of a marble, the outer edge of the atom would be nearly a football field away. The atoms are about 99% empty space. Electrons are kept in the orbit around the nucleus by the electromagnetic force. And because of that, our brain believes that we touch objects. So the empty space is not just empty, but vibrant with energy. Not only our physical body, but also energy body and spiritual body are made up of energy. So we can survive only when we produce energy. There are three primary sources of energy for human beings. We can boost energy through the air, food, and people. In K-Wellness, they are respectively called chun, ji, in. When you get energy sufficiently from these three sources, our mind and body will be healthy. The primary source to recharge energy is breathing. We eat 3 times a day, but we breathe 20,000 times a day. Lots of people care so much about their food, so we find organic food and natural food. But how about breathing? How much care and attention do you put to your breathing? Our day-to-day breaths are pretty shallow. We call it chest breathing. And a lot of adults are predominantly chest breathers. What does this mean? We end up not getting as much oxygen as we could. What we need is slow, deep breathing that activates your belly. Check out my other videos for healthy breathing. When people don't get sufficient energy from breathing, then they naturally tend to get attached to other energy sources, like food or other people. And if you get too much attached to food or other people, then it can create some physical and emotional health issues. Even when you recharge yourself with energy, if you use more energy than that, it will be problematic. On the face of it, you might think that we will use a lot of energy when we engage ourselves with a lot of physical movement. However, it is our brain that uses more energy than any other human organs. While the brain represents just 2% of a person's total body weight, it accounts for 20% of the body's energy use. You might have experienced that when you are inundated with a lot of emotions and continuous thoughts in your mind, then you felt exhausted after that. Everybody has their own patterns of thoughts and emotions. When you are aware of with what kind of patterns of emotions and thoughts you drain your energy most, then you can better manage your energy and you can use your energy more productively and effectively. You would feel fatigued when you use more energy than you produce. Energy is the source of life and is directly connected with all life activities. However, we have forgotten how to regulate and how to feel the energy in our daily lives, while we have no idea how much energy we waste through our endless thoughts and a lot of emotions. We just want to steal energy from others. And then we feel so fatigued and we just passively let other people steal my energy. People call them energy vampires. But when you understand the energy principles and train to accumulate and circulate energy in our body, then we can live a life abundant with energy. Let's see how we can feel energy and utilize it in our daily lives. I will guide you on how to recharge your body and mind through breathing and meditation. And also, I will create videos about energy principles and Tao meditation. Like this video and subscribe to this channel. Thank you. 감사합니다.